Greetings, everyone. Welcome to Secondary Weekly, where I try to highlight some news stories from the previous week that you may have missed or flew under the radar. If you're interested, all sources and other information will be listed in the description. Now, let's dive into this week's stories. Adding to its list of incredible firsts, the Mars Perseverance rover was able to extract oxygen from the Mars atmosphere for the first time. Using a machine called MOXIE, the rover separated the oxygen from the carbon molecules in the air using a conversion process with temperatures nearing 1500 degrees Fahrenheit. The process captured the oxygen molecule and released the carbon monoxide waste back into the atmosphere, which is 95% carbon dioxide. The process was a critical experiment which showcases the viability of both traveling to and living on Mars without transporting oxygen from Earth. The largest miners' union in the United States has agreed to back President Biden's agenda to move away from fossil fuels. The president of the United Mine Workers of America, Cecil Roberts, explained that this is contingent upon providing jobs to those who are currently employed by the coal industry. This comes as Congress debates Biden's proposed $2.3 trillion infrastructure package. Senator Joe Manchin of West Virginia added that the need for human infrastructure, i.e. jobs, is paramount when considering alternative energy. The Mine Workers Union called for tax incentives for renewable energy and preference in hiring of dislocated miners. A recent poll by Gallup has found that the most pressing environmental problem on American mines is water pollution. More than 50% of those surveyed displayed a great deal of concern about potable water and waterways. However, the level of worry amongst Americans in regard to almost all environmental dilemmas has generally declined since the turn of the century, except for global warming. Generally, most US citizens thought the environment throughout the country was in good to excellent condition. Accompanying the explosive growth in cryptocurrency is a similar fear of its effect on the environment. One Bitcoin transaction uses about the same amount of energy as 750,000 Visa swipes, creating about 660 pounds of carbon dioxide. Because Bitcoin transactions are maintained on a public ledger, millions of specialized computers work around the clock to create space to confirm transactions and get rewarded with Bitcoin. The annual power consumption from these rigs is equivalent to the countries of Chile or Austria. To make matters worse, many mining rigs are also set up in China, which sources almost all of its electricity from the burning of fossil fuels. Now, I will wrap up with Highly Curious. Researchers in Japan have discovered the first new centipede in 143 years, and only the third known amphibious centipede ever. According to the scientists, the centipede measures in around 8 inches, with a venomous bite that would not kill an adult human, only cause agonizing pain. Researchers at the University of Pennsylvania have made advances in improving vision in children with congenital blindness using a new method of gene therapy. The scientists injected the gene GUCY2D into the retinas of 3 patients, who were then monitored for 2 years and showed improvements in vision with no major side effects. An Israeli-American startup, NFT, has unveiled its design for a flying car, with the pre-sale price tag set at nearly $800,000. Called the ASKA, the street-legal vehicles would be capable of vertical takeoff and landing. A study reported in the journal Nature Communications found that lack of sleep could lead to increased risk of dementia. The study followed 8,000 people for 25 years and discovered that those who averaged 6 or less hours of sleep showed a 30% increase in risk of dementia between the ages of 50 to 70. Finally, for this week's video, check out this Vice News explanation of how spider silk can be used as a sustainable material in the construction of clothes to airplanes to suspension bridges. And that's all for this week. Let me know down in the comments which story you guys thought was the most interesting, or if there's anything I didn't cover that I might have missed. If you guys enjoyed the video, it would be awesome if you could like and subscribe. And of course, remember to have a great week.